is a drumming superstar and propelled Bhangra music to new heights in the Western world.
Oh, fantastic. He is number one. I mean, the way he approaches, the way he comes in, his entry is unique.
From humble beginnings in India, Gurcharan Mall now plays to fans around the globe.
I've always been a big fan of live music at games. I think the drums really pick up the intensity.
After decades of success, he's still recording and teaching the art of drumming. But how did Gurcharan Mall rise from a poor background to make his musical fortune?
Going to Africa, Bombay, Singapore, New Zealand, that was wow for us.
In this program, for the first time since leaving in the 1960s, he returns to his home village as we trace the story of the man who's become known as King G. Mall. The Dhol Drum, the traditional Punjabi instrument. It was a drum played more discreetly in the background of Indian music. That is, until Gurcharan Mall got his hands on them and made the drum the heart of the performance. Now in his sixth decade, Gurcharan is returning to his roots, leaving his UK home in Birmingham and flying back to India and his birthplace, the tiny village of Hakimpur in the Punjab region.
The doors are just opened for this young man who was actually born in this house, going back to 1952.
One of his sisters shows Gurcharan around as the memories flood back. His childhood in this rural area seems a world away now.
In them days, there was no such things as chairs or desks. There was tappad, like what we call it, mats. In Punjabi, we call it tappad. So there used to be just tappad to sit on the floor. And instead of having books, we used to have small slates to write with a chalk. So things are very, very different compared to now.
Even the workers in the fields find time to enjoy the music of their famous countrymen. And the local children are keen to show they can sing as well. At the age of 4 and a half, the family moved to what is now the large city of Ludhiana.
Going back to 1960s, this used to be just a completely a quiet road, a very narrow road. Now it's double the, triple the size, but look at the traffic, and this is only early in the morning, at 10 o'clock in the morning, and there used to be about 3 or 4 shops just here, and there was just one Gurdwara at the far end, and these used to be just empty, and just a quiet road, but look at it now, beautifully livened Ludhiana.
Again, this is the first time he's returned since leaving as a child. With his sister's help, they find the old family house. But while there's been a lot of changes, the young boys of today still play here, just as Gurcharan did.
It's like a happy occasion, but at the same time sentimental, because them days it was a big, big step for my dad to take for the sake of us, so we can get better education from the village to a big city. So with getting a good education to get a better job, so the standard of living could be better. Never ever thought we'll go to England. Even when we was in the village, we never thought we'll move into a big city, Ludhiana. So it was thanks to our parents, our dad, who thought bigger things. So then it was thanks to him, when I was 11 and a half, going back to late 63s, end of 63s, early 64, that we moved to England.
In the city of Chandigarh, Gurcharan catches up with a fellow performer. Another artist who's made it in the world of music, the singer Balbir Sufi.
ਰੂਹਾਂ ਖੁਸ਼ ਕਰਦੀਆਂ, ਸਮੀਤਾਂ ਖੁਸ਼ ਕਰਦੀਆਂ।
ਯਾਰ ਅੱਜ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਵਾਰੀ ਦੋ ਬੋਰਡ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਵੇਖੇ ਨੇ, ਇੱਕ ਬੋਰਡ ਦੀ ਛਾਂ ਤੇ ਇੱਕ ਢੋਲ ਦਾ ਬੋਰਡ, ਦੁਨੀਆ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਬੋਰਡ ਹੈ।
Next, we're on the road to the place that's known as Dhol City, Ambala. They still make dhol drums here in the traditional fashion, starting with the raw timber. This is the drum that's made his fortune. These workers still only just survive with the money they make.
The shocking things that we've seen, the true reality of how they make the tools and the conditions and the hardship that they make these tools. Sometimes, because we live in England, we don't give that sort of compliment or credit to the people who make these tools. But all we do is saying, oh, there's a little crack, there's a little filling, but not realizing hard time these people have, and the amount of money that these, the payment that they get, they're enough, just enough to earn and fill their tummy. So friends, you know, thank God to these people that I'm carrying the tool that they make.
After an emotional journey to India, it's back to the UK and Birmingham, which became home to Gurcharan, his brother and parents. A big lifestyle change for a young boy in 1963.
This country had the biggest snowfall for many, many years. Sitting in the front room, looking outside, a thick white snow coming down, first time we ever seen in our life. But the reason we came into this country was that we wanted to get education. My father was already here. Majority of the Asian people who came from India, that was the reason, to make a better living.
Gurcharan qualified as an engineer and toolmaker and still uses his skills to maintain and upgrade drums. He developed the use of stands, straps and amplification for dhol drums to allow performers like him to take centre stage. But engineering wasn't to be his career path.
In the evening he used to work at the beer keller. And then from there, sometimes he would work at the cinemas. So he was quite active. And then when he had other spare time, then those are the times when he would be playing around with his musical instruments.
And when he decided to try and go for it and become professional, were your mum and dad worried? Did they think, oh, he should be doing engineering?
Yes, they were. Yes, certainly dad, because he thought there wasn't any money in entertainment. Whereas with engineering, it had status and it was a stable income. I can remember the first time they formed a group, they used to practice upstairs in the house, and father used to get quite upset because of the noise and what the neighbours are going to say, what the relatives are going to say. Yeah, he tried to, in some ways, discourage Gurcharan not to take it seriously. It was okay to play at the temple or at the mandir. It was more or less like service in the house of God. But I don't think any of us thought that he was going to turn full time.
And all my friends, all the English gentlemen, they were saying, Gurcharan, you're saying to us, there's no money. And then you're packing a job as a foreman, having a good job, to something you don't know whether that's going to bring you any money or not. But it was a gamble I took, and thank God it paid off.
Continuing to develop his interest in music, he performed with a number of groups, including the Nadans. As well as drumming, Gurcharan was making his name as a Bhangra dance producer. The Trangra group were one of the award-winning teams.
The funny thing is, because I was more into Western music than Indian music, funny, and although I used to practice and play with my Indian bands, but if I have to go out and see somebody play, I would go and see either the Beatles or the Rolling Stones, because the reason was, when I used to watch them, they used to excite me. They used to bring something in me. And then I used to say, hang on, how come our bands are not doing that? Because our bands used to be very stationary. The singer would just hold the mic and just sing, or he would have the mic on a stand and just play the tambourine. Very, very static. Even the beat players, everybody. I'm the first artist in the history of Asian music who actually brought movement into the... Because I said, hang on, if I'm going to play the drums, I'm not going to get no recognition. So I need to create something. So by watching artists like the Rolling Stones and the Beatles and how they used to move on stage, so I brought that into my drumming. So that's how people start to recognize it. They think, oh my God, this guy's on drugs, or he had a few drinks, because they've never seen anything like it.
But it was with the band Apna Sangeet that Gurcharan Mall really made a big breakthrough in the mid-1980s. There was a string of successful albums that saw the band play around the world. The records Apna Sangeet, Tour India and Mira Yar took the group to the next level. They earned the nickname the Big Drum Boys, with the dancing Dhol player taking a lead part.
That's when Bhangra music started to play a bigger role with youngsters. And that's how when bands started to perform in nightclubs and they used to start doing competitions and everything. So 80s was when things started to lift up for Bhangra music and for us. And then 90s was even bigger. I never ever thought, as a married person with four children growing up, going on a holiday or whatever. No, through my music, we went to Canada, God knows how many times, America, Singapore, Malaysia, Australia, New Zealand, Africa, all around Europe, and even thank God that I ended up in teaching in some of these countries.
He's done a wonderful job. I mean, we've been listening to Bhangra folk music for many, many years now, but it's always been in the background. You've never seen the dholis play dhol right in the front, but he's a person who's really brought it to life. You know, he's come out with the dhol right in front as a lead player, and you know, he's just brought a whole new concept, and it's brilliant. And without a dhol, you can't really have a Bhangra music. It's the main thing that, you know, creates that, you know, music itself.
There's only two words, the man with the golden dhol, because I remember when I was a little lad and watching Paji perform, you know, and he was playing dhol. I remember I was only little, and for a few songs, you know, he brought this dhol out, man, and he was playing the dhol, and he was acting and dancing. I was amazed. I'd never seen nothing like this before, because other players, they used to just straight, you know, in one position and just play throughout the show. You could feel that he was loving what he was doing, you know, and he was showing it by his actions and everything, and everyone was loving it. I remember he used to go on his knees and go like this, because I remember when we used to play in Tanga Pangra group, and the old used to say, yaar, you do some acting like Bhaiya. I go, well, I don't know that acting, you know. And I used to be small and I had a big dhol. And one time they were saying to me, go like Bhaiya goes on the floor and does that, try to do that. And I tried to do the dhol, went on top of me. And I couldn't get back up. So after that day, I never tried again.
Come on. Say what? we were surprised because once he produced one album, other groups started inviting him to play on their album. Because to play the Dhol, it was a new thing. Nobody had heard of it, a Dhol being played on the on an album. So it was a bit of a novelty, but also a bit of specialism as well, because he was the only one that produced the sound in the way that he did.
But gaining such a high level of success came at a price. He regrets not giving more time to his growing children when he had the chance.
The biggest credit goes in my life to three different people. One is Almighty God for giving me the strength and the energy and the heart to work for the communities, all different communities and charities. Secondly, my mom, she's my God. She's my mom, she's my God, she's my friend. And then the next one is my wife and my family. Over the years, I haven't taken my kids out. I haven't been to their school. I never been to their parents' evening. I never took them out. I just purely sacrificed my life to my Punjabi arts. So that's why I say thanks to my family, to my wife, my brother, everybody. Without them, where I'm today, I would not be.
Gurcharan performs and produces with many different acts, the Dhol Blasters being one of the most prominent. Big shows continued, including at Live 8 with UB40, and he became a world record maker. A non-stop playing record was set at 53 hours, and then in 2009 in Birmingham came the world record for the most Dhol Drum players, 632, all playing at the same time.
Amazingly loud. Yeah, it's really loud, but it's really good how they all keep it all at the same time.
It's good to see so many people here, actually. Breaking the world record is quite an important thing, obviously. And it's good that many people have turned out for it.
Yeah, it really gets down deep into you, doesn't it? It's just fabulous. Incredible atmosphere.
To all of us, all the children, brothers and sisters, boys and girls who came from very, very far away, from the UK and abroad as well. So this record is not mine. It belongs to everybody who took part. And we are so proud and happy that we've done something very, very positive.
Old friends from the hit band Apna Sangeet returned for the world record event.
Amazing, some of the youngsters ages 3 to 4 years old who are coming with the Dhol, and then they can't hardly pick the Dhol up, but they're playing it, which is absolutely brilliant, brilliant.
We have to support him, so this is our cultural instrument. Without Dhol, we don't celebrate anything. Whenever any happiness, we play Dhol and we enjoy.
For King G Mall, being based in the UK, but playing modern and traditional Asian music has meant an opportunity to bring people from different backgrounds together. The song and video for Awaji is a perfect example, sung by four non-Asian artists from different countries in Punjabi.
I think this is the great success of him. Because when we talk about multicultural and intercultural relationship, we only never have thought about the music side or the Bhangra side. And we have been talking about other things which we have started, our community cohesiveness and this and that. I think this music which has got no language barriers to anybody at all. It is just the music which brings the people together. It creates no barriers between the color and the faith or the white or the black, whoever they are. If the people like the music of any nation or any culture or any faith or any color, I think that music brings back. This is what he has done.
This music is for entertainment, no dancing, which Bhangra music is for entertainment, so people can dance and enjoy. Any group they used to perform, they know Gurcharan Mall. I remember when he released this calendar, The Man with the Golden Dhol. So he loves the instrument and he promoted it very well, still doing it, and many youngsters he taught, you know, Bhangra dancing and Dhol.
So Tilli, Daga, Dage, and to hold them.
Passing on his skills and experience as a drummer and introducing the Dhol to a new generation is as important as ever.
After four, one, two, one, two, three, four.
The sports world is yet another outlet for live performances, including playing and dancing at games featuring the Leicester Riders basketball team.
Leicester Riders, go, go, go!
I thought it was fantastic. I've always been a big fan of live music at games. I think the drums really pick up the intensity in here, and I think that if he can come back, it would be great. You know, he's got a big fan in me.
King G and his groups put smiles on people's faces at many major public events. Gurcharan Mall says he won't forget his roots. Now his career has an even bigger focus on raising money for charity, including sending funds back to India.
£10,000 for Gujarat earthquake. We raised money for Pakistan earthquake. We done it for children hospital in India and also orphanage homes in India as well. So Ethiopia, Uganda, you name it. Anywhere there's a famine or there's earthquake or whatever, anybody just need to pick up the phone, say, Gurcharan or King Ji, we are doing this. Could you help?
He takes social responsibility as his main motto. Personally, from my experience, I've called him for many events where it's a multicultural event, it could be a sports tournament, it could be something for the children, for charity, and he does give his time out. He is a very serious player in that. He will come out, contribute his time, everything towards that, and that's what makes him a wonderful person, that where he's earning a living from as a business of Dhol, but at the same time he's contributing it back to the community, and no matter what color, race or culture it is, he is committing his time back.
Despite decades of success, retirement is not something he could ever imagine.
Good afternoon, how are you?
Yeah, no bad, sir.
You good?
Yeah, all
right. Lovely, thank you, sir.
He's the one who I think took the Bhangra music right at the level of other music, and everybody up and down the country, here as well as in the world, people talk about Bhangra, the dedication and the commitment and also the natural instinct in him. If you don't have these three things in you, whatever profession you are in, you cannot deliver. Once he's on the stage, he's a changed man. He's a changed man. And he is such an attraction to the people. The way he creates the scene on the stage, it's entirely different. So that's what popularity he has created all over the world.
Gurcharan Mall is one person. He was when he was any group, if don't matter what group, they used to insist everywhere you bring Gurcharan Mall with you, because he's brilliant entertainer and player. So he's a very this is natural thing, you know, performer. Someone might be a great player, but when he gets on stage, he's not very good performer. Some people have it naturally, and Gurcharan Mall is one of them natural guys. Even when you meet him, he's a very jolly guy.
May God bless us all. Yes, sir. Yes,
He's a people's person. He enjoys making people laugh. He enjoys seeing people happy. And I think it becomes reciprocal. So people enjoy his company and he enjoys theirs. I've seen him go to places where it's very quiet and people aren't so bubbly. And he then starts the party going. And then everybody joins in. And wherever he goes, he actually sees each party as his own. I don't think he differentiates that I don't belong to this party or I'm just here as an entertainer. I think he embraces them. And maybe that's his magical formula, that he embraces wherever he goes.
My family and all my friends and all my fans, without their support, and every time I'm feeling down or if I come off the stage, they say, oh man, that was good. You know, not just Asian people, but a lot of non-Asian people. I have emails from people that have performed. I don't know who they are, but they said, yeah, we've seen you at the NEC, or we've seen you set so-and-so. So because of that, that's what keep me going. This trophy was for the best Dhol player and the best dancer. Then we got a platinum disc from a record company, Natural Records. This is from UK Asian Pop Awards. This shield going back to like 1974, 75. A certificate from a police inspector for doing supporting their charity, raising money. This we done for a big thing for charity. So my dancing teams and my Dhol drumming teams. And these are just some of the trophies over the years for my dancing team, for my Bhangra teams, for Dhol teams, and individually myself. The biggest honor was going back to where I was born, going back to India, and get a big award from Parth Parvesi Award for the NRI. So that's it. And now I will give you a small little demonstration, now, which I practice for 50 years.
The awards for his recordings and charity work seem almost endless, but it's the energy and irrepressible personality of King G that has helped forge his place in Bhangra music history.